Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel, JT Open Stuff. Today, guys, we are going to be opening up these Zuru Robo Boats. Now, if you've watched the channel for a while, you know I've also opened up some of the Zuru Robo Fish and the Zuru Robo Turtles, but today is gonna be boats. Now, you may not have seen these boats in any of your local stores. These particular two that I have came from Hobby Lobby. So, a really appreciated place, I guess, where you can pick up some toys and some mystery balls and things like that. Hobby Lobby is definitely a place you want to add to your local hunts when you're out looking for new toys to open. These are really cool. I got a couple of really cool designs, I think. We're going to open them up. We're going to take a look. We've got the water back here ready to go. So with no further ado, we should say, we'll get right into this and let's see how these stack up to the RoboFish and RoboTurtle. I thought it was a really cool idea to actually have boats. Obviously, they're not to scale to, say, the turtles or the fish, but they are really cool looking. And if they have the functionality of the fish and the turtle, they're going to be a lot of fun. So inside, you are going to get this kind of this little instruction booklet here. You see. Give you guys kind of a look at that. Just several different languages. And there are the designs that you can get. As you can see, we got the blue boat and the silver boat with little shark teeth on it, but there's also an orange and red boat as well. So lots of cool designs, or several cool designs, I should say. But this is the boat out of that big plastic wrap. And how do they have this in here? This is in here snug as a bug. Does it kind of pop apart here? Or how are we supposed to get into this thing, Zuru? Interesting. No real way of kind of popping it open that I can see. So be prepared, if you buy one of these, you are gonna have to apparently cut into that. So I'm gonna pause the video 1 second and I'm gonna grab something to help get into this package and I'll be right back. Right, guys, I'm back and I think I found something that's gonna help us get into this package. Back from its absence, the grandpa knife. So let's open this guy up. And obviously we always cut away from ourselves. When we are trying to get into any sort of packaging, we always just cut in a manner that we will not hurt ourselves. So let's see if that did the trick here. Looks like it. Oh, and you can hear it. It's already running. That is pretty cool. Oh, look at that. All right, guys. I'm going to have to admit, I might have just done something really dumb. Imagine that. I'm sitting here trying to break it out of the plastic. There's not even plastic on the front of it. If you look closer right there, there are just two rubber bands holding this guy in here. So I will take the L on that one and admit that I was kind of crazy there, I guess. But guys, I don't know about you, but it's been a long couple of weeks around the opening household here. I know a lot of people were just affected by Hurricane Helene that came ashore a lot worse than us, but it has knocked out power to hundreds of thousands of people in the area that I live in, which is just on the East Coast around Hilton Head, South Carolina. So you would think that was nowhere near where the hurricane made landfall. But honestly, guys, there are so many people in the Savannah, Georgia area, Hilton Head area, that lost power and are going to be without power even for a couple more days. And, you know, that's just some of the lightest damage that was done by Helene. So, you know, my thoughts are for anybody out there that was affected. If you're watching this video, hey, I really hope that everything gets back together, a little sense of normalcy for you soon. But been some long days, guys, long days the last couple of days, but we're safe. And I hope that you are too. And now that we figured out that it was just a rubber band, we can take a closer look at this Zuru boat. And as I said, you could already hear it turning on. So most of them have like little carbon sensors. And you can see. All right. Yeah, where you place your thumb on there, it definitely will turn that little motor on. And as you see, it's got a little prop right there. All right. Spinning away there. Now, it also is activated when you drop it into the water. So we're going to move our little water feature over. We're going to drop this guy in there. Let's take a look and see what happens. Oh, that is pretty cool. Little donut action there. Now, I will say, if you had a larger, like if you were playing with this in your bathtub or something like that, I definitely think you'd want to do something other than just spin in circles. But even so, look how fast that's going, guys. Compared to the fish and the turtles, this definitely looks like a little bit of a speedboat. A little action going there. And then, come on, there you go. I guess if you just let it go long enough, it will make a lap. But look at that water, look how fast that water's moving out of there. Just give it a little nudge here and see what happens. Back to its 360s again. All right, well, I tell you what, let's let that one continue to run back there. We'll see how long it goes. And we're going to go ahead and pop open this blue boat, and we're going to have a little boat battle. What do you say? Now, I did notice these have different color bottoms on there. I can't really tell any specific difference between the two. Same store, same time, but one had a blue bottom, one had a white bottom. All right, let's get this blue boat out of here. And this time, I don't think I'm gonna make the same mistake and try to rip it out of its plastic because, well, I'm just not that dumb. I don't think I would do something that dumb, but you never know. So there you go. What an awesome looking boat. You can see a little shark design on the side there. Silver and blue. Such a cool little design. Oh, and there you go, guys. So we let that go for about 30 seconds and it just shut off automatically. So that is cool to know that it will conserve your battery if you just kind of let that go. But here we go. We're going to take this out now. And you can see there are the little carbon sensors. So let's see. Where was it? Oh, where was that? You know what? I thought that I just had it. There we go. All right, let's get that one off there. Let's get that rubber band off. And I think we are good to go. And as you can see there, again, such a cool little propeller action. And look at this, guys. Now, I don't know. Maybe I made the mistake on the last one. There is a rubber band on the little rudder there. So if I left that on the other one, maybe that's why it was doing nothing but 360s. Let's do this. Let's get this thing out of here. And did I leave a rubber band? I did, guys. I did not. Look how close in color that was. I did not even see that when I was holding it up close to give you guys a look at it. But you can see that glimmer right there. There is a rubber band. So, wow, that is crazy. We're going to definitely get some better functionality here. Let's drop this guy back in there now. Oh, check that out, guys. It bumps and then it goes backwards. Still getting a little 360 action here. But it just hit nose first and then it backed up. It went backwards. See if we can recreate that when it hits something here. It's getting closer. Come on. Okay, look at that. See how it's going backwards? That is really cool. That is awesome. Let's get its friend in here with it. What do you say? These are really, really cool. The fact that they kind of back themselves out of trouble, you could bang them into each other and they would just keep going. That is really cool. Like a little demolition derby in the water, maybe? Well, guys, these are really, really cool. I think this might be my favorite one of the Zuru Robo Swimmers. I don't know. What do you guys think? You like the turtles, the fish, or the boats? Let me know in the comments down below. And guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. I'm going to let this play for about another, say, 20, 30 seconds. Let you get a little ASMR robo boat action. Thanks, guys. I'll see you in the next video.